What's going on, guys? My name is Pedrotsky, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can set up Levels Ranks Web. Levels Ranks Web is a CSGO ranking website that's for use with the Levels Ranks core plugin. If you haven't already got that one installed on your server, then just go into the description and I've got a video in there and it's going to show you everything you need to know. But once you've installed that, come here and I'll show you how to install Levels Ranks Web. So first thing we need to do is we actually need to grab the files for this. So if we come to their GitHub page, I'll leave a link in the description. It's pretty simple. We just click on code, click on download zip. Then we can just let that download and put that to the side for the second. Next thing we're going to need web hosting. Now you can go use whatever web hosting you want, but you need special extensions and a special PHP version for this, and things can start getting tricky. So I recommend just using Dreamhost. So if you get the Dreamhost, just their shared website hosting, that's $3.95 per month. You can have unlimited websites, unlimited bandwidth, everything. And you can also host your normal CSGO website from there, and your FastDL. You can also host that from there too. So it's just worth picking up, and it's going to save you a lot of headaches in the end, because I know this works exactly with it, and this whole guide is basically, it's going to be centered around using Dreamhost. So once you've gone ahead and you've set up your Dreamhost account, we need to prep our website. So basically you're going to be brought to like a home screen like this, and then we need to make sure that our PHP version is correct and SSL is set up on our site. So if we go to websites on the left hand side, click on manage websites, and then we'll just go to the website. For this demo I'm going to use lr.csgosurfrecords.com. so as you can see, my PHP version is already 7.4, but for you it's probably going to be 8.1, so we need to change that. Click on manage, and then it says here PHP. I click modify. We're going to set it, change it from 8.1. I'm going to set it to 7.4 fast CGI. And then you'd click change PHP version. And then there's like a little confirmation. It's already done for me, so I don't have to do that, but do that. And then it's probably going to take a couple minutes to change the PHP version over. Once that's done, we need to double check that the SSL is working correctly. So as you can see here, the padlock is green. If yours is, if it's green, then that's good. You're all good to go. But for me, like, I'll show you here, if we click on the little hamburger menu on the right hand side and click SSL security, and then we're just going to install the let's encrypt certificate, and there'll be a button at the bottom here that says something like install certificate or add certificate or whatever. Once it's done, wait like 10 minutes and your website should work. So if we go to lrcsgosurfrecords.com, go there, it's going to bring me to like this generic Dreamhost page, and the padlock on the top left hand corner should be, it should be locked like that. It should be, yeah, connection is secure. That means SSL is working, means your website is set up with Dreamhost, and now it's time to continue with the rest of the guide. So next thing we need to do, we need to download FileZilla, and this is used for transferring files to your web server. So if we click on download FileZilla client, don't click the green button. Come down here to where it says show additional download options, then just grab the 64-bit installer. The reason why you don't use the green button one, it includes bundled software, and this one doesn't include any of the bundled stuff. So just go through, get that installed. Obviously you know how to install the program, just click next, next, next. Okay, so we need to get set up the FTP user, so we'll just get the FTP user. So on the left hand side here it says FTP users, and then you'll see under domain name, for me it says LR CSGO Surf Records. Click on login info, and the first time you do this you will need to change the password. I've already changed it, but all you need to do is we're going to be copying these into FileZilla. So I'm just going to copy this post, copy the username, you put your password in. Now here's the thing That's important. We're going to be connecting to port 22. So port has to be filled out, 22. Quick connect. And that's going to connect us to... So as you can see, we got our domain, which is lr.csgosurfrecords.com. We're going to navigate to that directory. And as you can see, it's empty. So now we're going to get the file that we just downloaded earlier. Yeah, then we're just going to extract it. So extract it into this new folder. Go in. We'll see here it says there's a file here with index.php on there. Basically, we can just copy all of this into our root directory. So this is basically a website root directory. So we just copy all of this in. And then we have to wait the 5 or 10 minutes, whatever it's going to take to upload the file. So it shouldn't take too long. Once it's done, we'll come back to it and we'll continue. All right, so now that the files have been uploaded, now we can go to the Levels Ranks website that you've made and we can load it. You're going to see this error saying PHP extension not found. So we have to load the extension onto the Dreamhost con. So if we go back to FileZilla, and then you'll see here, if we go up one file, we can even see here at the bottom, we just double click this button, we go up one file, and then we can see there's a .php directory. We go to 7.4, and then the phprc file. We're just going to click on edit. Then just got a little line that you have to paste in here. I'll just put that in the description. It's to go at the top of the file. I can't go anywhere else, otherwise Dreamhost is going to override it. So just going to click on save. And then we'll just give it a moment. Yes. It's uploaded to the website now. So the Dreamhost will actually like scan this file periodically, so you could get lucky and could just refresh a page and it could work. But as you can see, for us it doesn't. So if we go back to Dreamhost, then we click on websites on the left hand side, boosted domains this time. And then if we just scroll down to where our website is, then we click on edit. And then all you have to do here, you just leave everything, don't even touch it, just click change setting. And it says here the changes should take effect within 5 to 10 minutes. This is basically just like force changing that file, and it should be done relatively quickly, like within like a minute. All right, so yeah, as you can see, that took probably about 60 seconds. So now we need to set some folder permissions. So it says here 777 permissions not set on directory. So we have to find these directory in FileZilla. So if we just left hand website on the right. So you can see side by side. Let's go back to the website root directory. So we're going to go up the folder. We just double click these like two dotted folder here. Go up another folder. Then we can see the that should be a website. We double click on that. We have to find this file path. So it's storage. Click on storage. Then cache. Click cache. Then session. This is a directory we want to set the permissions on. So we right click on sessions. Click file permissions. 777. Press OK, wait for it to update, then just refresh. It's going to give us a few more. Storage, cache, image. I'm just kind of going to speed through these ones a little bit more because I think there's like 4 in total. Again, 777. OK, wait for it to upload. Modify the folder. I want storage assets, CSGO. Yes. All right, so now we've come to the install of the website. It's kind of a little bit buggy, so I'll guide you through this as well. So let's click on English, well, Russian if you're Russian, but plenty of Russian guides out there. And then we want the levels ranks database. Now, you can get this database from the from the guide earlier. So I'm gonna just take you onto my server. I'm gonna show you exactly how you would find it again. So I'm just gonna go to my server full screen. I'm gonna go to my server instance. File manager. Again, your host is probably gonna be a bit different, but the file structure is going to be the same. CSGO directory. And you'll know you're in the right directory because it says like add-ons, maps, materials, etc. Click add-ons, source mod, configs, then database.cfg. Then we want to scroll down, we want to get the one that says levels ranks. So we're going to copy the IP to start with. Host is IP. The user. User, the database, which is going to be password, and the server name, let's call it sick CSGO server, game mode CSGO. We can just leave table. I wouldn't even touch this because you're just using default stuff at the moment, so let's just press check. And that's and now we have to enter our Steam API key. Now I'll leave a link on description on where to get this. For this demonstration, I'm just going to click on I do not use authorization via Steam. You'll need it for, you know, doing your admin login and everything, so you go through and do that. It's very simple, you just paste the code it gives you. It's simple. I'm just gonna click I do not need. Then here we give like the short name, full name and info. I honestly I don't know the difference between the short name and the full name. I think one of them's for like the title or something, but sick CSGO, sick CSGO, and then info. Sickest CSGO server ever. And then click on save. Now we need to figure out if we want things. So this one here is actually the sidebar. Do we want the sidebar open all the time or do we want it closed by default? So I'm just going to click open. Badges. This is like, do you want rounded badges on the site? And obviously there's no image for it, but I'm just gonna click one. I think the right one is rounded and I think the left is square possibly. Oh, actually, never mind. And this one here is the block edges, so the little edges on these side for rounded. And animations. And put it on. It's just a little bit nicer, but that does make the site a bit slower. That's it. Simple. So if you have your like your Steam login, there'll be a button up here that says like login via Steam, and yeah, you'll have access to like an administration panel here where you can do a bunch of other things. But that's basically it. As you can see here, I've got the profiles and stuff working. Now, if you do have like a lot of players, it is going to be pretty slow for the first little bit that you use it, just because it does have to like download all the player avatars and stuff, but it will speed up over time. And if you want it even faster, you can put it behind Cloudflare. But that's a whole separate video. For now, you've got a stat site set up, it's working, and I hope that made it easier for you. So I hope you enjoyed the video, guys. If you did like it, just leave me a like. Let me know in the comments about your server and community, and if it helped. And if you want to see any other videos, then let me know. So thanks for watching, guys, and I hope to see you in the next video.